1914, a clap of thunder shakes the modern world. The start of the First World War. Overall, the Solvay factories emerge quite intact from the conflict. But in the aftermath of the war, the company is in great danger. In the wake of the Bolshevik Revolution of 1917, the Russian plants are confiscated. In Europe, central empires totally collapse, and Solvay has to negotiate with each successor state. The chemical industry landscape changes tremendously. New high-value chemicals appear. Solvay chooses not to develop these new sectors and stands by soda ash production. Huge conglomerates appear in large countries. Faced with new major players, Solvay finds itself at a crossroads in its history. Should it become a financial holding or stay an industrial company? Solvay opts for the second solution. But its influence is greatly reduced, particularly in America, where its longtime partners declare their independence. The group retreats to Europe, which once again plunges into the abyss. War breaks out faster than expected. In less than 2 years, the German Führer, Adolf Hitler, seizes control of a vast part of the European continent. The expansionism of the Third Reich, also palpable in the economic field, weakens the empire Solvay built in numerous occupied territories. The challenge for Solvay's managers in the conflict is straightforward: to preserve the pre-war independence of the company in both occupied territories and the free world. Ernest John Solvay is in charge of relations with authorities in occupied Europe, whereas René Boel safeguards Solvay's interests in the Allied zone, where the group's holdings are equally under threat.
Il part en Angleterre en avance du gouvernement belge. Et durant la guerre, il va avoir un rôle d'envoyé du gouvernement, tant à Londres qu'à Washington, tout en exerçant les fonctions de ce qu'on pourrait appeler un gérant en exil pour Solvay.
1945, the war ends, but Solvay continues to feel the consequences. In Eastern Europe, Soviet communism succeeds the Nazi occupation. 15 industrial sites are nationalized east of the Iron Curtain and even become rivals to Solvay. To offset these losses, it is imperative for the company to conquer new markets in the West. With the onset of the Cold War, the United States emerges as an avant-garde, reliable, less risky place to invest money. But divergence in opinions among managers hinders a rapid comeback in the US. So when will Solvay be able to return to America